Now, there is a famous argument against scientific realism, and it's called the pessimistic induction or the pessimistic meta-induction. Now, the first round of this debate about the role of history of science in our current image of the world took place in France at the end of the 19th century, beginning of the 20th century. One of the participants, protagonists, was the famous philosopher and physicist Henri Poincaré, who in his address to the 1900 International Congress of Physics put the problem like that. The man of the world is struck to see how ephemeral scientific theories are. After some years of prosperity, he sees them successively abandoned. He sees ruins accumulated on ruins. He predicts that the theories invoked today will in a short time succumb in their turn, and he concludes that they are absolutely in vain. This is what he calls the bankruptcy of science. That's a part of a debate that took place in the late 19th century France, the so-called bankruptcy of science debate. Poincaré's intervention to this debate was to defend some kind of optimism about science, a qualified sense of optimism about science. He went on to say, the skepticism of the man of the world is superficial. He does not understand none of the aim and the role of scientific theories. Without this, he would understand that ruins can still be good for something. The same position was actually developed by Boltzmann, Ludwig Boltzmann, in 1899. He thought that lots of those who reacted against the atomic theory of matter appealed to what he called the historical principle that frequently opinions which are held in the highest esteem have been supplanted within a short space of time by totally different theories. This kind of pessimism, Boltzmann thought, is a kind of a double-edged weapon. So Poincaré thought that the history of science somehow undermines our current epistemic optimism about theories, in that it shows that there's a pattern of falsity accumulated in the past of science. This kind of argument became very popular in the late 1970s, early 1980s, and it was developed thoroughly by the philosopher Larry Laudan, who produced a famous list of successful yet false theories, such as the crystalline spheres of ancient and medieval astronomy, the humoral theory of medicine, the catastrophist geology, the phlogiston theory of chemistry, the caloric theory of heat, the vibratory theory of heat, the theory of circular inertia, the contact action gravitational ether theory, the optical ether, and the electromagnetic ether. Based on this list, Laudan argued for a certain sort of pessimism about current science and its epistemic credentials. The history of science is full of theories which had been empirically successful for long periods of time and yet were shown to be false about the deep structural claims they made about the world. It is similarly full of theoretical terms featuring in successful theories which do not refer. Therefore, the thought is, by a simple induction or meta-induction on scientific theories, our current successful theories are likely to be false, or at any rate more likely to be false than true. And many or most of the theoretical terms featuring in them will turn out to be referential. So that's a point about how the history of science and the record of the past record of scientific theories bear on our current scientific conception of the world. The target of this argument, which has become extremely popular among non-realists as a way to argue against scientific realism, is basically the third position of scientific realism, epistemic optimism. As I noted already, the epistemic optimist position says that there is an explanatory connection between truth and empirical success, that somehow the truth of a scientific theory or the approximate truth of a scientific theory explains the empirical successes, especially the novel predictions made by scientific theories. So the argument of the pessimistic induction proceeds more or less by a reductio of this thesis. The thesis is the current theories are approximately true of the world, but if the current theories are true, then the past theories cannot be true simply because they are inconsistent with what current theories say about the world. Then the historical gambit comes in, which says that past theories have typically been false despite the fact that they have been empirically successful. Therefore, the realist warrant for the claim that there is an explanatory connection between empirical success and truth is removed, is undermined. As Loudon put it, the pessimistic induction calls into question the realist warrant for assuming that today's theories, including even those which have passed an impressive array of tests, can thereby warrantedly be taken to be cutting the world at its joints. So how can realists react to this argument? There are various ways to react. One important way has been to challenge the inductive basis of the argument. Are there so many serious scientific theories which have been extremely empirically successful in the past, nonetheless false? There are various ways to restrict this list. For instance, arguing that only theories which yield novel predictions and are explanatorily mature should be included. So one way is to basically show that the inductive basis is not strong enough to warrant the pessimistic conclusion. However, whichever way you look at this past history of science, there are serious cases of scientific theories like the caloric theory of heat and the optical ether theories, which somehow satisfy the realist criterion of success, novel predictions and the like, but which turned out to be characteristically false. If we take these theories seriously into account, as we should, it seems as though the connection between empirical success and truth is still undermined. So, in my view, the way to react to the argument is to meet the challenge that Loudon puts forward head on. The crucial premise of the argument is the second premise. I repeat, if we hold current theories to be truth-like, then past theories have to be truth-like simply because they're inconsistent with what current theories say about the world. My reaction to that is that if we block this premise, that is, if we hold that current theories are truth-like and past theories are also truth-like in some sense, then there is no way in which the pessimistic conclusion follows. How can we defeat this premise? How can we show that there is consistency between what current theories say about the world and what past theories said about the world? We need to show, I claim, that the success of past theories did not depend on what we now believe to be fundamentally flawed theoretical claims. Put positively, we need to show that the theoretical laws and mechanisms which generated the successes of past theories have been retained in our current scientific image of the world. If this is shown, then there is enough continuity in our evolving and changing scientific image of the world to warrant the realist optimism that it's not unlikely that even current theories, despite the fact that might be proved false, will have substantial truth content which will carry over to newer domains, to subsequent domains of inquiry. So realists ground their epistemic optimism on the fact that newer theories incorporate many theoretical constituents of their superseded predecessors, especially those constituents that have led to empirical successes. The substantive continuity in theory change suggests that a rather stable network of theoretical principles and explanatory hypotheses has emerged, which has survived revolutionary changes and has become part and parcel of our evolving scientific image of the world. Guarded realists need not take current science uncritically. They need not commit themselves to everything that current science asserts. They can have a differentiated attitude towards the theoretical constituents of modern science. Some of them are better supported than others. Some may play an indispensable explanatory role while others do not. Some contribute to the successes of theories while others do not.